Community Edition. So to download the Uipath Community Edition, first you have to go to the Uipath website. So we will write www.uipath.com, and then we will go to the developers. Once we click on the developer options in the drop down, we will see Uipath Community Edition, and we will click on that. Once we land on the Uipath Community Edition web page, we will click a Get Community Edition button. It's getting some time to render the button, but we will click on the Get Community Edition button. We are on the Uipath Community Edition web page, and we requested for a Get Community Edition. The Uipath website will provide us a web form. We have to fill this web form. Simple registration form consists of first name, last name, email, and your work experience, your company name. You can provide company name to personal. If you are a student, you can provide that student, your country, and some basic informations. So particularly, we have to provide a email address and a valid email address, because in this email address only, the Uipath will send you the download link. Please mind that, don't provide any junk email address or any random generated email address. If you provide the random generated email address, Uipath will not able to send you the file, and hence you will not able to download. And do mandatory click on the checkboxes, and finally you have to click on the Request Community Edition. Once you click on the Request Community Edition, Uipath will store your email address, and it will send you the Community Edition license key version as well as everything in your email address. So we have to wait for the email to receive in our inbox consisting of the download link. Hey, I received the email. Now what we are going to do? We have to open the email. The email will come from Uipath Robotic Process, and we have to open that email. And once we open that email, we will have the download link. We have to click on the download button. Once we click on the download button, the process of the .exe file of the Uipath Community Edition will start. We have to save it and start the downloading. Save the file in the proper location or whatever you where you want. Our download has started, and we will wait for the download to finish. Our download got finished. We will click on the show in folder, and there the main .exe file. We have to double click on that .exe file to run the installation. The installation is really basic. There's nothing there to install. Once we have the download link ready, we have to save it and install it. The installation of Uipath is almost done. It already got whatever the prerequisites required to run the Uipath. Installation started. Now we have to activate the license. To activate the license, you have to provide the valid email address. The email address you have already used in that waveform, we have to provide that email address. And the device ID is populated or pre-populated. We have to click on that activate button. And once we click on that activate button, you will get a message on successful activation from the Uipath website. Yes, the Uipath has successfully installed in your computer. That's great. One thing I want to remind you is that for installing an Uipath, there can be a lot of errors we usually get while installing the Uipath. For getting rid of those errors, we need to install some prerequisites which we don't have in our system. If we have in our system, it's not an issue. If we don't have, you have to learn how to install those prerequisites before installing the UiPath.
So as you can see that we have got a .NET framework error. So don't get panic on that. We can easily solve those error by doing some very simple steps. So why we sometimes get these errors in some of our machines while installing the UiPath. So let's see what was the prerequisite. In the prerequisites I have mentioned to install a .NET framework. So for running this application a .NET framework is required. So that's why we have to install this .NET framework as a prerequisite before installing the UiPath Community Edition. If you don't have this .NET edition, don't get panic. Just go with the normal flow of UiPath installation, and as soon as you see this error, just click on this yes button. So let me the Chrome your browser gets popped up, and with the URL it has already required to download the .NET framework. So you can see that it is 4.6.1 was required for the installation. So the .NET 4.6.1 is there for web installer. Just click on download, and once you click on download, you have this package.exe file is required. Just go to this and save it somewhere you prefer, and just as the basic process of installation, just click on this. So wait for the download and just click on this and click on the yes button. So it will download the extension, it will extract the file, and the process of installation begins from here. So this, so once it will complete the installation process of the .NET, it will start, the UiPath will start successfully, and you don't have any problem in running the UiPath. So as my installation is finished, sorry, I didn't able to capture the finished installation message from the .NET framework. I missed that part. So let me start this UiPath Studio and see whether it is running properly or not. So if you have received any other errors, kindly ping me in the comment section or the post me in the Q&A sections. Okay, I will help you in solving the installation problem. It depends on the machine to machine, some errors are there, so we need to have this fixed it by own, or you need the guidance. If you need the guidance, kindly mail me or ping me or post it in the comment section. So I guess UiPath has started properly in my machine. Let me check. Yes, so UiPath has started properly. So there is no error, and we can clear to go to the next step of the video. Okay. So let's close up this session, and we will come back with the next session of learning the UiPath in details.